India and Pakistan today held a flag meeting at Chakandaba crossing point at line of control in Poonch district of Jammu and Kashmir. Field commanders from both the sides addressed the issue of ceasefire violations and modalities to defuse the tense situation in border areas. Home Minister Rajnath Singh today reiterated that India wants better relations with Pakistan and China. Speaking to newspersons at Samba in Jammu and Kashmir, the Home Minister said that India has always extended a hand of friendship and now Pakistan should reciprocate and take steps to improve the relationship. The Supreme Court today rejected a PIL seeking direction to the centre to declassify confidential documents on Subhash Chandra Bose. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley has said that the government is confident the new GST regime to roll out from the next financial year. Speaking at a press conference on the last day of his four-day visit to Singapore and Hong Kong today, he said that it's not necessary to implement the GST from April 1, 2016 as it is a transactional tax. According to NASSCOM, Indian tech industry contributed nearly 4,11,000 jobs to the US economy this year and $20 billion in taxes between financial year 2011 to 15. Minister of State for Home Kiran Rijiju has said that the government is closely monitoring the activities connected with ISIS in the country and will be taking necessary action. The Bombay High Court on Monday refused to stay the ban on sale and consumption of beef for the festival of Eid al-Zuha, which will be celebrated on September 25th. A petition had asked the court to relax the ban on slaughter of bulls and sale of its meat temporarily for 3 days for Eid. Markets closed in red on Monday. Sensex fell 26 points to end at 26,193 in choppy trade. Nifty fell 5 points to end at 7,977. The 11th e-auction of iron ore across Goa will kick off on Tuesday. A total of 1.17 million tons of ore will be up for grabs. With Bihar Assembly election round the corner, notification for the second phase was issued today. Voting in this phase will take place on October 16th in 32 constituencies out of 243 assembly seats. Last day for submitting the nomination is 28th September and scrutiny will be done the next day. Lok Jan Shakti Party, in its second list released today, has named 9 candidates. With BJP announcing the third list of 11 candidates yesterday, the party has till date declared candidates for 153 seats out of total 160 it will contest. Rashtriya Lok Samta Party has announced candidates for 17 seats in the upcoming elections. Criticizing Nitish Kumar, Rashtriya Lok Samta Party President Upendra Kushwaha said that since Nitish Kumar has joined hands with Lalu Prasad, lawlessness is being witnessed in Bihar. Jagmohan Dalmia was cremated with full state honours today in Kolkata. Jagmohan Dalmia's eyes have been donated as per his last wishes. Dalmia passed away on Sunday. Two labourers trapped more than 40 metres underground for over a week in Himachal Pradesh's Bilaspur district were rescued on Monday, bringing relief to their worried families after a long and tiring operation that had suffered many setbacks. Satish Tomar and Maniram were brought out by the National Disaster Response Force team at around 4:30 p.m., 9 days after they got trapped following a tunnel collapse. Great Britain reached the Davis Cup final for the first time in 37 years as Andy Murray outclassed Australia's Bernard Tomic in straight sets to give them an unbeatable 3-1 lead. World number 3 Andy Murray became the first Briton to win the Wimbledon's men's single in 77 years in 2013.